this class, we are going to discuss Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem is one of the important theorem or Bayes' rule. Some mathematicians are going to be Bayes' rule. It's one of the important rule or theorem. Whenever having uncertainty, means whenever you want to find out posterior probability value based on free law. In such cases, we are going to use Bayes' theorem and to take a find out a solution of the given problem. Just like your prepaid and postpaid your phones pay. In the prepaid means you know that before going to use, we are going to already taken charge for the mobile for 30 rupees or 100 rupees like that. Postpaid means for 1 month, what are the things you are, how much you are used, based on that you are going to pay for the money. That is a post like that. Under the probability, they have two type of probability. One is a posterior probability, another one is prelinear probability. With the help of prelinear probability, then you have to find a posterior. That is nothing but that is happen whenever you want to find out posterior probability based on prelinear probability, there we are using Bayes theorem. Actually, Bayes theorem is very much important to take a decision whenever they having uncertainty in the problem. Okay, now in the next step, before I'm going to explain the original statement of the Bayes theorem, now I to give one simple live example based on the easy to understand what's a Bayes rule or Bayes theorem. Yeah, now I'm going to explain based on one live example what's the meaning of Bayes rule or Bayes theorem. Now, for example, my initial is Kmar. Yeah, Kmar going to take in the probability class between 2 to 3, online class, online or offline, whatever may be. Now here, if you want Kmar madam is engaging the class between 2 to 3 means, at least one student must be in the class. Attending the class for the students are nothing but E1, E2, E3 like that. Suppose in the class having 60 students, each student's identity is nothing but attending the class for KMR classes, even E2, E3, etc. E60. Keep in mind, KMR is engaging the class between 2 to 3, whether offline or online. How is possible? Student must be at least one of the student in the class. Okay, fine. Suppose students in the class, then only we are talking about Kmar madam is engaged in the class for probability class between 2 to 3 p.m. Okay. In the next step, now if you want to write the probability of this Kmar is nothing but actually A is my is a event, is a probability of taking a class, probability of she is engaging the class is nothing but at least one student is attending, then only Kmar madam is taking class. Therefore, then if you want to write the Kmar madam is taking the engaging the class between 2 to 3 is nothing but either A intersection with E1. E1 is there, then only are expecting classes engaging, or E2 here, then we have classes engaging. Like that, how many students are there? 60 students. At least one student is attending the class, then only Kmar madam is engaging the class. Therefore, at least one must be happen, then only Kmar is engaging the class. Therefore, okay, please, class engaging means at least one must be there. Without students, how we are taking a class? No? Therefore, A is Kmar madam taking probability class. That is, or if you want to take mathematics class, if we want Kmar madam is engaging the class means one of the student must be there, both must be happen. Not only first student, maybe second student, maybe third, maybe all the students may be attending the class. At least one must be there. Therefore, at least one must be happen. If you want to find the probability of that Kmar madam engaging the class is the thing, but probability of A intersection A1, union of A intersection A2, etc., union of A intersection of A60. Okay. But attending KMR class for each of the students are mutually exclusive means A intersection of E1 plus A intersection of E2. Please try to understand, etc. At least one must be happen. Okay. Means this happened, this cannot be expecting. They are mutually exclusive. Attending E1, E2, E3, their own interest and they is only constant based on that E1, E2, E3, each one attending. Therefore, I have to take the probability, sum of the probability, okay? But if you want to write the probability of A, which one happened first? Student is there, then only class is engaged. Therefore, E probability of E1 into from the base, from the condition probability using multiplication theorem, A slash E1. E1 happened, then only A is happening. Means A class is engaging. Therefore, P of E2 into P of A slash E2. Like that. Probability of E60 into probability of A slash E60. This can also be written as summation P of EI into P of A slash EI for I ranging from how many students? 1 to 60. Please try to understand. Then after she engaging in the class, in between the class, she is going to ask one question in the class. Yeah, she is going to ask one question. That one of the particular students is given answer. How many students are there? 60 students are there. Out of 60 students, one of the particular student is given answer. That particular student given answer. Now, I want to see, please try to understand, while engaging the class for KMR, she asking one question. Then one of the particular student is given answer in KMR class. One of the particular student is given answer in KMR class. One of the particular student may be E1, maybe E2, maybe E3 or E60. I want to find out what's the probability of one of the particular student is given answer in the KMR class. Why I have to write probability of EI slash A means is given answer means class must be engaged. After the class engaged only we get a question. Then it is possible to give an answer one of the particular student in KMR class. Then it is enough to find out probability of EI slash A. Keep in mind, I want to find out probability of the particular student is given answer in KMR class. See, our classes happen, then only these things are coming. Question is raised and then he given answer. It is enough to find out probability of A slash A. But you know that what is probability of A intersection B from the multiplication theorem. Suppose A depends on B is nothing but probability. You know that probability of B happened, then probability of A slash B. Okay. This implies B happened, then only A happened. This implies what is probability of A slash B? A slash B is equal to probability of A intersection B divided by what actually probability of B. Okay. Like that. From this definition, multiplication theorem, this can be written as probability of A intersection B divided by probability of A. B is A. Yeah, you know what is probability of A, just written on the board. Sigma P of EI into P of A slash EI for I ranging from how many students we consider? 1 to 60. A happen means first B happen, first A happening means the particular student is there, then only KMR madam is engaged in the class. Therefore, probability of EI into probability of A slash EI. This is nothing but Bayes theorem or Bayes rule. You see, I taken one real example and explaining. Now it is clear. See, observe here, we have EI slash A here. Here we have A slash EI. They have ambiguity. Yeah. That's right. Now, here UI slash is there, we are having yes, then how is possible? Now it's clear. Now, before moving to the actual statement of the base rule, I'm explaining once again what is my base rule or base theorem. Cam or madam is willing to engage in mathematics class between 2 to 3 p.m. in the online or offline. She is engaged in class means at least one of the students must be logged in or one of the students must be in the class. Then one is possible to say the class is going on. Therefore, if you want to write A, A is nothing but either A occurred with E1, A occurred with E2 or E3, because in the class how many students? 60 students. E students are denoted by E1, E2, E3, etc. E60. At least one is happened, then one is possible. I have to find out what's the probability of Kim or madam engaging the class between 2 to 3. At least one must be happened is in between that I have to take union. And then I have to take probability. But attending the class of Kim or even E2, E3 are, we can't expect him. All are being attended. Therefore, I am going to take mutually exclusive. Therefore, I am going to take some of them. Probabilities. Some of the probability we written here, probability of A intersection E1 plus probability of A intersection E2, etc. Probability of A intersection E60. But if you want to write the probability of A is, means probability of class engaging by K or means at least student must be there in the class. Before student comes, then only A happened. Therefore, while from the multiplication theorem, this can be written as P of E1 into P of A slash E1. Like that, P of A intersection E60 is nothing but student happened, then only A is happening. Therefore, now by combining sum of 60 terms can also be written as I ranging from 1 to 60 P of EI into P of A slash EI for I ranging from 1 to 60. Okay. Now this is a for value for probability of A. The next. Now while engaging the class from KMR, she is going to ask one question in the class. That question may be answered from one of the particular student. The one of the particular student may be E1, E2 or E60, because totally how many students are there? 60 students are there. While taking KMR class between 2 to 3, she is going to ask one question. One of the students is giving answer in KMR class. I want to find out what's the probability of the particular student is given answer in KMR class. Means probability of EA slash A. Why I written A slash A? Class engaged, then only question arise, then the student may be answered that question. Therefore, answering the question is depending upon whether KMR engaged the class or not. Therefore, that is nothing but probability of A slash A. I want to find out, but from the multiplication theorem, what is probability of A slash A can be written as probability of A intersection AI divided by probability of A. You substitute the value, but A cannot be happen exclusively. A happen means A must be happened. Then only A happening. Means no students are there. How you are expecting class is going on? How is possible I to find out what's the probability for class engaging the KMR between 2 to 3? Therefore, now P of A into P of A slash A. See, observe, I want to find the probability of particular student is given. I may be 1 or 2, maybe 3 up to 60, any one of the value. This is nothing but my base rule. Means with the help of previous value, previous probability value, we are finding posterior probability. Yeah, except this theorem is not you answer any method. So many probability distributions are there, testing the hypothesis is there, so ANOVA is there. But except this rule, you can't take a decision for this type of situation. Whenever you want to find a posterior probability from previous, the suitable rule is nothing but our base rule or base theorem. I think it's clear. Then same thing I return what about this rule, base theorem, general statement from this rule. Now I think it's clear for this part. What is a base rule, a base theorem? Now, this is a thing we are expecting from the students. Yeah, see, based on that, I moved to what actually my base theorem general definition. Okay, yeah. Now, Bayes' theorem general definition is nothing but actually now suppose we are going to take a minute. So suppose we are going to take my base theorem general statement is actually if an event is nothing but Kramer engaged in the class is nothing but my event. Is opening my board. Yeah, Bayes' theorem is nothing but actually in an event A can only occur in conjunction with one of any mutually exclusive and exhaustive events. Mutually exclusive and exhaustive events, say even E2, E3, then even E2, E3, etc. They consider in the statement totally. Totally they consider n events, say even E2, etc. n. And if A is actually happens, then the probability that it was preceded by the particular event EI is given by probability of EI slash A is nothing but what I written few minutes before, the same concept we are going to write it on the board. I think you are clear for this part. I am going to explain original base theorem in the next class. Okay. Bye. See you and take care.